having us up here today and showing us around the loft and that. Can you tell us a little bit how you got into pigeons from the start?
No problem, Eddie. I started pigeons in 1982. I was only a child of about seven. I started racing in the Dublin North East in 1988, and I've raced ever since. I was a member of the Ballymun Club for a couple of years, and I've been in the Boyne Valley now for since 1987, I think. I'm sorry, 1997 till now.
Herbie, can you tell us a little bit about some of the boards you've won with and some of these boards here we're looking at now?
Well, the first pigeon there, when I bought this house 17 years ago, I brought them over in a bowl, would be the check pie cock there.
It's the one on top, yeah?
Yeah, no, the one in the middle.
The one in the middle, yeah.
His parents would have came from John Hayden. John Hayden, the mother of that pigeon topped the fair down Mary Man for John Hayden, I think it was 1995 or something. That was the start of that family there. And I went right up to, if you see, Lee's boy won three races for me in 2015. He was paired to the King's Cup pigeon. There's four generations of winning from John's business. John was probably the first man that got that actually the pigeons won for me.
And some of the other boards are in?
Well, if you touch pigeon dick there, same thing. Me and John went to the north and bought what's the name of the pigeons? John Kaiser pigeons. And the father that was bought at that sale at that time. The pigeon went on to win five races and top fed cards for me. Where he's first year breed and he bred a seven fed and he bred a pigeon to fly the King's Cup. And this year, the best pigeon I have in Sun City is Elton. The Mealy is again down from John Hayden's junior lines. Won five races for me. Never let me down. The Bungle pigeon is at Terence O'Brien's. Badger Junior is Terence O'Brien's. Caitlin was 32nd year of the National for me. And Terry Day would have been one of my best races. I retired him when he was only two, and he'd first club 9 fed, first club 10 fed. But I retired him because his grandfather stopped filling. That was Badger, belongs to Terence O'Brien. But as it has it, Terry stopped filling as well at the age of 7. But he's bringing me a lot of top class pigeons, top national pigeons. Even really good pigeons on the year of the national.
What about these boards over here, then?
That's the family of pigeons. The Pied was, as I say, I brought him over here 17 years ago in a bowl, and he raced here for 2 years, and then he's badly caught by a hawk. I put him to stock and he just bred winner after winner for me. Taylor would be a son of his when he was paid to Mary Tiddens O'Brien's Open winner, and then Badger Junior was bred out of Taylor. And then Badger Junior has bred Lee's boy, which has won three races for me. His first club 4 fed and his first club 88 open. And his only race, he was injured early on in 2015, he was paired to Baird Scare, the King's Cup pigeon. But he only got one race, it was the last race of the season, and he won it and went into the DTW in the club. Baird Scare is the King's Cup winner. She's half Sushin, half Jansen. The Sushin came from Davy Hutchinson. And the Jansen came from Jerry McCourt. She's a pretty consistent pigeon. She flew all as a young board. She was my fourth pigeon out of the year of the National in 2014. And she was my first, she won a race up the land in 2015. She flew 7 land races in 2015. Then she went to Bude, which was my second pigeon. She went to Penzance, she was my first pigeon. She was third club. Then she went on to win the King's Cup the following week. Would be a Sushin, Davy Hutchinson's, paired to a Van Loon pigeon, which bred the father of the babysitter, paired to one of Thomas Brogan's Mandabeelies. The babysitter was given to Jimmy Cavanagh as a present, and went on to be first club, first open, Talbany, first club, seventh open, Penzance, and second club, 32nd open, Senecove. He got the Meritorious Award for the best channel pigeon of the year in December 05.
And the Carlo Hen?
The Carlo Hen was Jeff Bourne bought her at an auction. I wasn't available that day. Jeff bought her. She was second club, second open into El Torso into Carlo for a fella Jimmy. And toured open then, toured open El Torso as well. There's only two pigeons home, I believe, when she was second open, and only three home when she was toured open.
Right, NASA.
Yeah, NASA was given to John McLaughlin by John Nash as an egg, and John went on to race her, and she won France three times, and she won the Open three times. She got the gold medal for John McLaughlin. So John gave her up here to me to breed off and as a present, you know.
Mm-hmm. And PROUDSTOWN Co MEATH.
PROUDSTOWN Co MEATH was bought by Davy Hutchinson. She was actually one of the first pigeons I purchased off Davy. And look, she went on to breed me a few good pigeons, and now the King's Cup. She did that in the King's Cup pigeon. Very scary.
And PROUDSTOWN Lad?
PROUDSTOWN Lad, I bought PROUDSTOWN Lad off Jerry McCourt in 2007 as a baby. And he went on, he bred me a few very good pigeons, and went on to be the sire of Bert Scare.
With my daughter Courtney as PNC Swindale. We only fly national races from France 500 miles.
And can you tell us a bit how you got involved into pigeon racing?
Well, when I was a small boy, I used to catch them with a bin lid and a piece of string on the side of the road. Hopefully we're trying to catch them with rings on them. and that was the start of it. We caught pigeons and then we got a wee loft up and we started going to local fanciers, and great fanciers like the famous Harold Elliott, King's Cup winner Frankie Phillips, Tom Marshall, all gifted us pigeons to start us off racing. We won our first race when I was 15, and we topped the open against 29,000 birds from Dungarvan when we were 15. We escalated from that to long distance racing with Harold Elliott and Frankie Phillips, and have been obsessed ever since, 45 years later. This year we have won two RPR awards for the children, middle distance champion, RPR award winner. Last year the kids and myself won best long distance pigeon of Britain, RPR award. To date I think we've won 7 RPR awards. We have clocked over 220 pigeons from 450 mile from the NIPA, Irish National Flying Club, and most of all Irish National Home and Union National Flying Club. This is our first year in 2016. We were 3rd National, 5th National, 7th, 9th, 11th, 12th, 15th, 16th National St Mullow. Only 16 birds home in race time, of which we clocked 9 of them, the children and myself separately. Courtney races separately with the two brothers, and rivalry is great. The first pigeon to be clocked in France, the other partnership has to do the dishes for 3 days. And I'm still doing the dishes. I haven't beat the children in 3 years. Courtney, she looks after all the rings, the stock birds, the single breeding pens. She's responsible for the paperwork. I'm doing the paperwork for the nationals. And I'm responsible for doing all the work, and she lifts all the prizes. So that's basically how we started. We've continued our next venture. We're hopefully going to have a go at Barcelona at some stage. Hopefully this year we should have some birds in for it. It hasn't been flew in Ireland for about 60 years. And it's 997 miles to our loft. We are great close friends with Herbie Thorpe, King's Cup winner from last year, or from 15, who has won the fastest King's Cup winner in the history of the Irish National Flying Club. And he has a phenomenal record in club racing right through to the King's Cup. The stock loft today is basically down to me. I have had single breeding pens, guaranteed the parentage, and Herbie has now followed suit. And this is a phenomenal place with a phenomenal fancier. Kenny and Herbie are two gentlemen. I could say other things off the camera, but I love them to bits.
And can I ask you, what line of breeding do you...
Well, I'll tell you what I've done. I started off and I bought some of the best pigeons in Holland, all in Belgium and everywhere. And they couldn't stand the pace on Irish racing, on the cold Irish sea, right out the Pentas. So they had to go. And I basically started and worked with Irish long-distance pigeons. And in 7 years I've built my own family. So I can't really say that they started off with Tom Marshall's, a couple of Davy Blacks, which are no longer there. I have Ronnie Williamson ones, and I've combined the base pigeons for my loft are Dave Goddard's of Reading. Top, he's won 4 or 5 gold medals, Spanish diploma winners for, he flies 710 mile from Barcelona and 600 and 88 mile from Palamas. So our pigeons are all one big family now, and we only fly France. That's our only race point. 3 French races a year. And they must fly it as late breeds and yearlings, or we don't keep them.
Can I ask you, what kind of feeding would you?
Well, I feed a heavy mix in the middle, the first week, sorry, start off. In the winter, I feed better in the winter than I do in the summer. Because pigeons must have a constitution in the winter, they have to keep warm, they need lots of multivitamins, and they need lots of protein in the muscle tissue. Because if they don't get it in the winter, they won't race well in the summer because they're weak. And it's cold in the winter. So what I do is I feed heavy mixes in the winter and light mixes in the summer. The week of Tilbany, they go on high racing mixes because we need them for France. They must do 1.25 to 2.25 hours a day flying morning and evening. We do very little training, but Herbie Thorpe and myself has been great friends, and Herbie is now doing a great mixture on anybody that's flying sprint, middle distance and long distance. Everything's here for them, and at the end of the day you need good mixtures and good feeding when you're going to fly national racing. You can't do it on barley.
And as a newcomer to the sport myself this year, can you give me any tips?
Or? I can give you tips. Stay away from pigeon men as much as you can. train hard, feed hard and train hard. You'll get the same result as training light and feeding light. Try to keep a regular basis. Get up in the morning, do your pigeons once a day. Once you get your youngest to fly an hour, they'll fly an hour's old ones. It's what you teach them as babies is what they'll keep as adults. If you don't learn them to trap the whistle as babies fast, they won't trap on a Saturday when you're looking to win. So what you teach them as children, young birds, they remember forever. So if you teach them bad habits, you've only yourself to blame. Don't keep too many. Try and keep the best. Feed good corn, good quality clean corn. Plenty of multivitamins in the drinkers. And train. Don't be training too often at the start to get them confidence built up. And don't do silly things like jump them 60 mile. Take them in stages, 5 mile, 10 mile, 15, 20. Don't overfeed them on a Friday, because your young ones will not trap on a Saturday. And they don't need excess weight. You need that nutrition in their muscles on Thursday and Friday morning for a Saturday race. At the end of the day, you're flying an hour and 10 minutes. Can't carry too much corn for an hour and 10 minutes. You're not going to be a success. So don't overfeed. Announce an eighth, announce a quarter a day for sprint racing up till about 140 mile. If it's going to be cold, add a little protein to your mixture, because they're going to lose a lot of body heat. Never train in northeast winds, because you will put the pigeons off getting cold winds on their face too often. The only time you want your young one to have a hard race is the day you want to win. You want your young ones to make it think it's easy. Plenty of training in warm weather.
That's brilliant. Thanks very much for that.
You're welcome.
Cheers.
And if you don't win, it's not my fault.
Well, Herbie, what's the boys you have there?
This is Bert's girl. She's the 2015 King's Cup winner. She broke all records by being the fastest pigeon ever out of King's Cup. She beat the second pigeon to her was 82 yards behind her.
Nice. What's that one you have, Lee?
This pigeon, she was a young board national winner from Penzance, and she also bred second open quimper, eighth open quimper. What was the other result?
She's 32nd open quimper. She's bred a 50 in a national pigeon as well.
Yeah, she's a great breeder and a great racer.
And this board here?
This is the famous Red Bull. He bred 1st open quimper, 34th open quimper, 12th open King's Cup, 3rd open Lombard, 15th open St Mullen National, 77th open St Mullen National, 35th open Pentis National, and 43rd open Pentis National. This King's Cup, this pigeon here is compared to these two great hens. The fastest King's Cup winner ever, Bert's girl, and the blue hen that won the Pentis Young Bird National. Leslie Woodside's Pentis Young Bird National winner. Red Bull's been paired to both of them, and Herbie and me are sharing the young ones to improve her stock lofts at 500 mile.
Very nice. Taylor, what's the pigeon you have?
Snowy.
Snowy? Mm-hmm. It's a racing pigeon, yeah? Mm-hmm. Well, loads of races for you?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. It's just your stock loft, isn't it?
Is that how you stuck left, yeah?
Yeah.
What's this pigeon you have in your hand?
This is a pigeon, a cock pigeon from I Have a Dream, the 2014 Barcelona International winner, hens. And it's off another St. Vincent's National winner.
That's a phenomenal pigeon, but look at it. Mm. It must be a great handling pigeon.
Lovely handling pigeon.
Let me see it. Oh my goodness, the muscles absolutely hanging off it. He's got a phenomenal wing, a single tail feather, well balanced, beautiful, superb pigeon. What age is this pigeon?
He's a 2014.
My goodness.
His mother won the international race in 2015.
International some performance. That's a phenomenal pigeon. I wish you all the best with it.
Thanks.
What's this pigeon, Kenan?
The impressive pigeon of Davy Hutchardson.
Impressive? That must be Hutchardson's number one stock here. Wow, my goodness. Sujan pigeon. Beautiful. Well balanced. Great wing. Beautiful. What has some pretzel got to do with your King's Cup on it?
Your pretzel would be a grandmother in my King's Cup.
And the grand would be a grandmother to the Miller last year's Miller Gold Cup on it as well.
His grandmother, yeah. I don't know about that. I don't know. It's off the Kildare Cup, I think.
It's off the Kildare Cup, is it? These Sujan pigeons are phenomenal pigeons, crossed with Irish long distance pigeons. They have a record in the top 10, which is second to none. There's about 10 or 15 top 10 positions in the King's Cup for a lot of men with Sujan crossed. It would be a perfect cross for the like of this pigeon here.
Right, Lee, what have we got here?
Well, Eddie, this is my favourite pigeon in the loft. At one time I had a loan of this pigeon. He's a Van Herk. He's a Belgian Van Herk. Billy Harris originally brought him into the country. And he loaned him to me. He was good enough to lend him to me. And he bred me a Thorpe fed Skibbereen, 9,000 pigeons. It was a very fast race that day. His grandchildren won for me. Then Thomas Grogan bought this pigeon. And the last win he had to break the record in the Fingless Club was down off this fella and his 21 hen. It's actually a brother to this one here. So Tom Grogan was kind enough to lend it up here to Herbie. Just so hopefully there's a few more future winners come out of it. But he's a beautiful cock. He's a very friendly pigeon as well. A good character in him. But he's actually liking it in here. And he's paired up to a Willie Van Herk hen in there. A PJ Ball Van Herk.
Well, Lee, can you explain a little bit about the new stock loft?
Well, as you can see, it's all brand new, Eddie. There's 40 pens in here. And we obviously made it accessible from the outside. The water, the food and the grit, everything comes in from the outside. There's no disturbing the pigeons. This line of pigeons is all Hutchins and Sujans, crossed with Van de Beebe's and some of Herbie's original pigeons. So the idea is to just do it twice a day if they're breeding.
And can you tell us a little bit about what you feed them?
It's all just natural mixes. At the moment it's a light mix just because they're not actually feeding youngsters yet, so it's a all round mixed in with a light breeding mix, finesse start from natural. And they just get that until they lay, and then when they're sitting about 10 days we give them a heavier mix, depending on what Herbie's choice is at the time.
And they've just recently been paired up, all these boards, yeah?
They're all paired up about 7 days, and they should be all laying in the next couple of days, all going well. So the temperature's warm enough in here at the moment, and all going well, they should be all sitting by Tuesday, I'd say. It's now Saturday.
How many rounds will you take out them?
Maybe 4 or 5 until May or June, depending on the demand for young birds. At the moment he's doing race kits of 10, and most fanciers are just buying 10 young birds and they're racing them on. And any young board that comes out here, there's actually a prize, €500 from the top of the young board race. That, from the best velocity in either the Irish South Row Fed or the East Coast Fed. And any young board with a Proudstown ring on it, except Herbie's ones, obviously. He's not allowed racing it himself, you know. So yeah, that's hopefully, it's all new in here, so hopefully it's going to be a success for him. So at the moment I'm just giving them a hand and just getting everything ready, because as you can see it's a lot of work involved, and you know it would take 2 hours to feed these, even though it is handy. It's a handy system, you know. You have to make sure every pair is healthy. No hens getting their head picked off them. Make sure eggs are right, make sure droppings are right. You know, it's a full-time job nearly, you know. But looking forward to it.
Hey, what's this beautiful blue card?
That pigeon is the is the Channel Pigeon of the Year in the Irish South Road Fed 2015.
And what has he won?
He was first club, first open, Talney. First club, seventh open, Penzance. Second club, 32nd open, Sandy Cove.
Boy, that's a fantastic pigeon. Well balanced, plenty of muscle, not too big. Beautiful eye, lovely pigeon all round. This is the babysitter. And Herbie, what's the babysitter paired to?
The babysitter's prepared to the Carlo Hen, as I call her. She was second open out torso and third open out torso.
Second and third open out of Thurso?
Yeah.
My goodness. Many birds was home in both those races?
There's only two pigeons home in the fourth race when she was second and three in the third race when she was third.
In total?
In total.
That's a phenomenal pair of pigeons together. Both eyes complement each other. Pearl to orange. Herbie, what's this pair of pigeons?
They're two DiCaprio pigeons, grandchildren of DiCaprio.
I'm just looking at the pedigree of these pair of pigeons. It's phenomenal, it's outstanding. The father of this pigeon, this checker hen, was bred seven first clubs, first 3,500, first 1,600, second national 6,000, third 10,600, 10th 2,800, 14th 22,000, 25th 25,000, third open 27,000, 45th open 23,000, my good, 33rd 21,381. My goodness, they're phenomenal performances.
Yeah, good pigeons, yeah.
Outstanding. Where would you go to get any better?
That's it.
I would have no idea. Herbie, what's this pair of pigeons here?
The cock pigeon is the pencil fella. Is off Bijou with Philip Bowl. She's an RPRA award winner.
What's the blue hen?
The blue hen is off Perfect Light. Perfect Light won two opens in the NIPA. And her father's Philip. He won an open as well. But Perfect Light was the fastest pigeon from north to 250 in the whole of UK, 30,000 members.
That's a phenomenal pair of pigeons. And Philip Bowe is flying out of his skins with them.
Yeah.
He has really treated you well with that pair of pigeons.
He has indeed.
You're very fortunate to get those.
Yeah, he was a nice fella now.
Herbie, what's this pair of pigeons?
The cock pigeon is a Wynans, Chris Wynans pigeon from Belgium.
And what has he done?
This pigeon was raced by Chris Wynans. He won an open, he won a couple of races, and he's plenty other positions in the first 10.
And has he bred anything to date?
He's bred a force fed fed topper for Tommy Gregory.
And what's the hen?
The hen is of Sheldon Leonard's Showman 2, and he's Chris Wynans' hen.
And Showman 2 is a what, a John Sane pigeon?
John Sane pigeon. The sisters, it's half sisters to this pigeon, was second open year in the National, and just Blue Savannah is in that pit breeding as well.
Well, the Wynans pigeons in the north of Ireland, in the East End Common, has won five or six opens.
Yeah.
Up to 5,000 birds. They're phenomenal racing pigeons.
Yeah. Well, I've just got three pairs of them now.
Yeah. And you have a son or a daughter of Gordon Brothers' famous number one pair.
I do indeed. That's in the next pen there.
That's a direct son of the number one pair.
It's a direct son of the
number one. Is that of golden eggs?
That's a golden, yeah. And the pigeon, the grizzle in the next box is off his broken wing cock.
It's off the broken wing cock, that's the grizzle wing, his cock had done all the racing.
That's him, yeah.
The Gordon Brothers has a hell of a record with these pigeons. It's phenomenal. And they're a great bunch of fellas. Mm. What breed are these, Herbie?
These are direct Van de Beelies from Van de Beelies Loft.
Van de Beelies are very, very, very expensive at the minute, worldwide.
They're dear enough, aren't
they? They have a phenomenal record all over the world for every fancy that receives them.
Well, I've only these pigeons in since 2015, and already we've had one reported first club, ninth fed, 10,000 pigeons. We've another one reported first club, 22nd fed, 6,500 pigeons. And I've one myself that's had three fed cards and the national card. He's ninth fed Ross Carberry, ninth fed Skibbereen, 10th fed Santa Claus. And 66th open year in the National.
That's phenomenal, you've just received them, you've just got them.
Yeah, it's the fastest family of pigeons that I ever won for me.
And how many pair have you?
I've six direct, but I've about 30 Van de Beelies.
They would be phenomenal. Are you going to cross the ones off the direct pairs?
I'm going to cross them with Sushan pigeons.
For high bred vigour?
Well, the pigeon that has the three fed cards and National card is a half Van de Beelie, half Sushan.
That's phenomenal. Phenomenal racing performances, and you've only received them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Herbie, what's this blue cock?
This blue cock is the son of Bolt 2 and the Olympia Gare.
And Bolt 2?
Bolt 2 is a brother to the Bolt pigeon that was sold to China.
Right, and that's the next best breeder?
Yeah.
Is Bolt 2?
Bolt 2.
And Olympia Gare is what?
Olympia Gare is one of the Flanders collections. It's 200,000 paid for a father.
And what are we doing? What's this cock going to prepare to? This hen?
This hen. This hen is a half-sister to the Olympia pigeon Flanders collection this year. It'll be shown in the Olympia now in 2 weeks' time.
In 2 weeks' time?
Yeah.
Well, that's a phenomenal pair of pigeons now.
Yeah.
These are some of the most sought-after pigeons in Europe.
Yeah.
Herbie, what's this pencil blue cock off?
That pencil blue cock is off Andre Rudhoff's pigeon Tom.
The famous Tom?
The famous Tom, yeah.
And what was Tom?
Tom was first ace pigeon 2005 and 2006, second in 2000, sorry, first in 2006 and second in 2005, and he bred a national winner as well.
And what's this cock paired to?
This cock is paired to the Caprio hen with the daughter of Tom from Andre Rudhoff as well.
And Rudolph's a legend, they're all around the world. Spent the middle distance racing.
Middle distance, yeah, very good. Yeah.
Herbie, we're in one of your racing lofts now at the minute. Can you explain which loft this is now we're in?
This is one of the widowhood cock lofts. It's three widowhood cock sections with 12 boxes in each. We've 20 cocks for racing this year.
About the breeding of these pigeons and where they came from?
There's three or four different people. The main person which would have given me my first winners would have been John Hayden of the Dublin North East. And Terdens O'Brien, and crossing them I started winning races, and then I went Jerry McCourt as well, obviously, which gave me this sire of the King's Cup winner, and Davy Hutchinson's crossed with the other family has given me pretty good pigeons, King's Cup winner and a Fed champion.
You were telling me earlier on that one of the King's Cup winners flew into one of these sections here?
The top left hand corner is where the hen raced back to a 3 day old youngster.
And what was the name of that board?
Bates Girl.
Bates Girl, you were showing us earlier on in the video, yeah?
Yeah.
Can you tell us a little bit about the board you're holding there, Herbie?
The board I'm holding in my hand at the minute is a half Davy Hutchinson pigeon, half Van de Beely. He's only a yearling pigeon last year. He was 9th fed Ross Carberry, 9th fed Skibbereen, 10th fed Sandy Cove, and 66th Open Yearling National. He's probably one of my best racing cocks at the minute.
Very nice. And can you tell us a little bit about the feeding, what you'd feed these boards for racing or?
I feed PLX.
PLX?
Natural PLX now.
And you have that in stock here?
I do indeed, yeah. This blue white fly pigeon, it was the pigeon that topped the fed for me out Kilmore Beach in the second last race this year. When I was both second and fourth fed.
Herbie, can you tell us about this board you're holding?
The mother of this pigeon came from Mark Bourne, a rare rock pigeon, which bred him all his French winners, you know.
What's this one you're holding, Herbie?
This red hen is one of my favourite pigeons. She's flown the Youngboard Talbany, she's flown Youngboard Penzance, she's flown the Ireland National, and she's also a fed card in the Skibbereen race this year. I'm looking forward to sending her to France next year. Hopefully she does well.
This one you're holding, Herbie?
This young board is a golden ring pigeon from this year. She flew Talbany and she flew the young board Penzance. I'd mark the golden ring pigeons with a golden clip on, just so we can identify them in the loft easy.
And can you explain to me a little bit more, you know, what a golden ring is on these boards?
Air club runs it to earn money for to pay the likes of the insurance and a few of the bills of the club. So what we do, we sell 400 rings and it's 10 for 50, or even if you just want to buy one for a fiver. But what happens is there's £1,000 prize money in the Youngboard Talbany for the golden ring. Broke down into five different prizes. You have 500, 300, 100 and 250s. So it's just a way of the club surviving. Like.
Pretty good. Can you explain what kind of system this is, Harry?
A race around the roundabout system. The hens, when they come out and train, they're normally out 20 minutes before the cocks. And the moment they're locked in one of these boxes after their first feed, then they're let out in the evening for another flight.
What's this board you're holding, Herbie?
This pigeon is a blue hen that was my second pigeon out of King's Cup last year, in 2015 when I won the race.
And she's raced on the roundabout system
she's
as well,
She's raced on the roundabout system. She also, in 2016, had a fourth club in it, and a second club. But she got injured and didn't get to go to the King's Cup again this year.
What's this one you're holding, Herbie?
This is one of Paul Swindell's pigeons. Paul gave me up a few to race. We swapped a few pigeons to race. And Paul asked me to use his system by getting them into France as yearlings, you know. So I'm looking forward to sending them. I've still 8 of them left out of 9, so I'm looking forward to sending them to France this year.
A little bit about the ventilation and the heating system in your loft.
Well, I got these heaters in 2 years ago, just before I won the King's Cup. And I keep them set at 16 degrees. Keeps the lofts at all times warm, nice, and keeps the cocks especially in good form. The ventilation is simple enough. It's just a few inches out in the front of the loft, and the air comes in and around the loft and back out, you know.
And can you tell us a little bit about this system here?
That's just to do with the heating system, to keep the humidity and the temperature right.
And that keeps it at a set 16 degrees.
I just set it at 16 degrees and keep it set that, yeah.
We're here in your new shop, Herbie, down in Proudstown. I see you're doing a lot of pigeon feed now. Can you explain a little bit about the new feed you have here in stock?
Yeah, Sheldon Leonard is the agent for natural breeding, getting a bit of food through Sheldon and the Brog Camp stuff as well.
And this is all like for breeding and racing and that, yeah?
Breeding and racing, yeah.
Herbie, I have young boards weaning at the minute, so can you explain to me now what I should be putting my young boards on before I start training them?
Eddie, I'd be putting mine on to young board no maize and breed and wean finesse.
And what kind of mix is that?
The natural mixes for young boards. A lot of people have got don't like to give the young boards too much maize at the minute, so that's the young board no maize. And the breed and wean doesn't have a whole lot, it's only a small bit of small maize in it.
And my own stock boards now, what should I have them on?
Well, if they're breeding, I'd be using the breeding maxi. It's a very good breeding mix.
And what about hens and that? Before, the lads are telling me that I should keep them tight on their feed. You know, is there a certain feed I should have them on?
The promotional mix like is a light mix for wrestling pigeons. It's the cheaper mix we have at $14.50, you know?
Yeah. That's about the booklet you're holding there.
Yeah, this is the Brockcamp booklet, and what I like about it, it gives you all the systems inside for when pigeons are young pigeons after weaning, feed and drinking plan for young pigeons after weaning, drinking through plan for professional young board travel, preparations for long distance flight, provisions plan for the breeding. It tells you how to use all the products. I think it's a very good booklet, you know.
And you have this booklet here for your customers?
I have it here, yeah.
Take one with them?
I do indeed, yeah.
Free of charge, lads. Yeah. There you go. Tell us about the feed we're looking at here, Herbie.
The feed we're looking at here is PLX. This feed, Terrence O'Brien in 2003 persuaded me to use this. And I normally won a race or two each year, but this year I won 5 old board races on the trot using this mix.